In LUSAS version 20, the reinforced concrete slab and wall design facility has been improved. It now includes shear checks and has also been updated to reflect the workflow for reinforced concrete frame design. In this example abutment and wing wall shell model, I have four load cases: the self-weight of the walls, the soil pressure acting on the walls, the dead load from a deck acting on the abutment, and the live load from a deck acting on the abutment. These load cases have all been factored and combined for appropriate design situations. If I go to Design, RC Slab Wall Design, I can choose the country and design code that I want to work to. I also can define some basic parameters which will be the same for the whole model. I can then go to Attributes, Design, RC Slab Wall Design in order to define further parameters which can vary for different surfaces within the model. As well as Wood Armour and Clark Nielsen, we also now provide the sandwich model method. This is from FIB Bulletin 45, featuring the most comprehensive up-to-date model for reinforced slab behaviour, and it's our recommended approach. Eurocode users will know this as the Annex LL method. Within the Shear tab, I can choose whether I want LUSAS to provide shear reinforcement and calculate shear reinforcement required. For this example, I won't be providing any shear reinforcement. I then need to assign this design attribute to the appropriate parts of the model. Through Attributes, RC Slab Wall Reinforcement, I can define the longitudinal and transverse reinforcement. Again, this can be different for different surfaces within my model. For this example, I'm going to start with the default values. And again, I'm going to assign that to the whole model. We also need to define a results transformation to ensure that our reinforcement direction and moment directions align in a logical framework. Within this model, all of my surface axes have been aligned such that the local x-axis, shown with two arrows, is horizontal, and the local y-axis, shown with one arrow, is vertical. This means when I go and define my results transformation, I can choose to transform into the local coordinate of the parent feature. As for any shell elements, the parent feature is the surface. Again, this needs to be assigned to the appropriate parts of the model. We can then turn on the contours layer in order to have a look at our results from our RC slab wall design. We're currently looking at a check for an individual load case, as the active load case is the self-weight load case, and we can see our utilizations are all relatively low. Rather than doing different checks for individual load cases, it's much simpler to go to Design, RC slab wall design results, where I can define a container saying which load cases will be used for which design checks. So for our ULS design checks, I'll use my ULS envelopes. For my SLS characteristic checks, I will use my SLS characteristic envelopes. And for my SLS quasi-permanent, I'll use my SLS quasi-permanent load case. We can then set active this container in order to see the envelope of all the different design checks on all the appropriate load cases. And what we can now see, looking at these contours of maximum utilization, is that significant portions of our model are failing, with a red contour showing a utilization of over 1. If we right-click on the container and show results, we can have a look at the detailed results. Sorting by maximum utilization, we can see that the high utilizations are all coming from our ULS checks. Looking at our ULS tab, and again sorting by maximum utilization, we can see that the high utilizations are all coming from VRDC. VRDC is a utilization of concrete in shear when no shear reinforcement is provided. And we can clearly see that this has been exceeded in some places. If we were to choose a design attribute where shear reinforcement is provided, we'd stop looking at VRDC, and instead we'd look at VRDmax, the utilization of concrete when shear reinforcement is provided, and ASSH, the area of shear reinforcement that we need to provide. Switching back to the Summary tab, if we click on Detailed Results for selected row, we can see the calculations for all of the individual checks that have been done. For each check, we can see all of the inputs and also any code clauses that are relevant. Coming down at the end to the final calculation, showing us our utilization, and here highlighted in red because it exceeds 1 and is therefore failing. We can choose to print out these calculations to put them in a folder or add them to a report to be printed out within LUSAS later. Reinforced concrete slab and wall design is now available, including both bending and shear checks, for design codes from these regions. And similarly, reinforced concrete frame design, i.e. for beams and columns, is available, including both bending and shear checks for design codes from these regions.